All right, it's about to start raining, but we're gonna try to get at least part of the excavator in the shop here. Try to get this thumb installed. This is how it came. This came from Showtime Fabrication. Two boxes, 155 pounds. And I'm gonna go around and try to get everything set up before it starts pouring the rain. So first things first, we're going to try to get this pinned on to this pin, which means we need to take the stuff off that I kind of pre-prepped before. If you haven't seen that video, go one video back and you can catch a glimpse of that. I'm going to pop this pin off real quick. Still got the air hammer and everything set up. And we'll get this installed. All right. So got it opened up here. Basically everything's pretty much shrink-wrapped. I see hoses, a cylinder, and a pin. So this came FedEx, 155 pounds. Packaged really well. Looks like everything's here. We're gonna get started on this main pin. The first step is to actually get the thumb pinned on with the new pin. Going to show, this may help other people. That right there is probably the most efficient way of getting this off. Just put the hook in there and you can grab it. Cut this saran wrap off. It looks like this pin is going to be really similar to the old one. I know a lot of people complain. My old one has a grease fitting here on the end, and grease comes out of this hole here. That's pretty typical. A lot of people complain about it because it breaks in the middle, but I've never owned a mini excavator that's had that happen. I'm sure it does. But this is pretty much the same as the stock pin. Let me get a set of snap ring pliers to pull that snap ring off. All right, so I've got a pair of snap ring pliers. Took the snap ring off opposite of this grease fitting. I'm gonna slide it through. Alright, so the first problem, I'm going to take some measurements. It looks like either the coupler is kind of slightly spread, or it's just a really tight fit. It's probably maybe an eighth of an inch. This is not going to fit. So I'm going to take a look and see what's actually out of whack, whether it's the thumb, see if it's something I can possibly spread, or see if I can pinch this. Now, this could probably stand a little bit, be a little pinched. But in either case, it looks like we're going to use some hydraulic tools. Alright, after some really quick hydraulic persuasion, I think we're ready to try to get the pin aligned. Okay, once the pin's in, I'm just going to get a little closer here where I can manipulate it. But now we got to go into the boom side. Let's change the camera angle here. Alright, so now I'm not sure that I had to kind of spread this just a little bit. I barely got room to get that pin in, or the retaining ring in. We'll see if it'll go. I think I'm going to be just short of that fit. So close. It looks like they made a concession for that roll pin to go on. We'll try to get it lined up here. Okay, so what I'm hoping, I want to try to drive the roll pin in. And in theory, that's at least going to put a little bit of inward pressure on it. All right, we're about 4 hours into the install of this thing. I just now got the pin on. I didn't figure there was a lot of point in me videoing all the grinding that I did. What I'm gonna try to do is kind of show you what I actually did to make this work. Okay, so this, obviously I had to apply a little bit of pressure to get it to fit. This coupler doesn't appear to be broke. It's in relatively good shape. And there's a support here. These ears pretty much are parallel with these. The thumb's just a smidge too small. So I took it back off, cleaned off the edge, see if that would gain anything just by the dirt that was in maybe in between this. That didn't help. I ended up actually grinding the outer collar off to make the snap rings fit. And also I had to do a little bit of work. The roll pin size on the pin that was provided in the kit is slightly off. I could not actually get the roll pin through. At first I thought it was just an alignment issue, took it all the way back off and tried to put the roll pin in. Took a measurement with an intermic, and it's a few thousandths smaller than what the hole size needs to be. So what I did is I ended up doing a tapered roll pin. I cut a roll pin in half and basically put it through both sides to hold the pin. So this is on now. I'm going to continue on. I'm not really sure whether it's just an issue with my particular machine or the manufacturer of the thumb itself is a little off. But regardless, I was expecting to have to do a little bit of fitting, but not quite this much. But it's on now. So I'm going to roll this up, get all the hydraulic cylinder stuff out. I will say the kit was well packed. Everything seems to be here. This is a high quality thumb. Other than this little issue of the roll pin size not fitting and the it being just a little bit too tight. Anyway, I'm gonna get to it. Next step is to kind of roll it up and hook everything up on the boom. I'm gonna have to kind of reposition. I wanna be welding up like this if at all possible when I do the weld. So I'm gonna try to get the machine in that position and see how that works. Okay. We got the bucket back on. Here's the thumb. So I've got it basically tilted back. There's two little pads that come off of this where the pin rests, that rest up against the boom here. And what I talked to them about is basically what you want to do is let that be resting, mount your cylinder with about an eighth inch of the cylinder extended. So that way when you come up and it hits this boom, you don't ever bottom out the cylinder. So this should be pretty easy. I'll need to clean this off. We'll see where that mount ends up at. It doesn't appear these pins are going to be really easy to get out. I really need an extended pair of these to get up in there and get that pin out, but we'll see what we can do with these. Looks like there's just enough room to do that. So I'll slide that out. I'll go get the hydraulic cylinder and we'll get it laid out here on the boom. This looks like a whole lot of fun to get lined up. Not a huge amount of, there it went. Not a huge amount of taper on those pins. So let's put that C-clip back on. That went on easier than I thought it would. So basically what you're wanting to do with this is center this up on the boom, make sure everything's aligned, check your fit with your bucket. This is a stock John Deere bucket. I think CP makes these buckets. There's a wider bucket, that would be more ideal. This one still works because it basically comes down right on the edge and this comes down right on the cutter. So this will still work with a small bucket without any issues, but you definitely want to check the fit. So what I'm going to do now, get this in place, I'm going to push this up an eighth of an inch. So we want an eighth of an inch. Let me get this in exactly where the position is. So this comes back and this contacts the boom. The thumb here has two little pads that hit this boom. And then I'll weld this in with this extended an eighth of an inch. All right. So now we're getting ready to put on some of the hydraulic fittings. And mainly this is just so I can adjust the pressure. So one thing is the fittings that have O-rings, you don't need to put any pop sealant. But I am putting a little bit of pop dope on these fittings. Anyway, I just want to hit that real quick. So I'm installing the quick connects now. Okay, we got it tacked on. Now I just want to check and make sure all the motion's okay. Make sure we're still centered up. I'm really going to go one more pass over this to clean it up. And we'll do the finish weld. Now we can do the finish weld. We'll get a wire brush. Okay, now we can do some finish welding. Okay, this should be welded on. I did a really good root pass. Had a little bit of issue. I got the shop door open and that was kind of blowing my gas away. It's kind of getting a little wind blowing. We got that resolved. And basically made a good root pass. Did a couple little circle-es and filled it out. May not be the perfect weld, but it's definitely not coming off it. Okay, just double checking, no interference, that comes down plenty. to allow the thumb to work. It folds up probably tighter than at least any Bobcat I've used. So this should work pretty good. Now all I gotta do is hook up the hydraulic lines. One thing I have to do is I have to set the relief pressure on this, or at least check it and make sure it's around, I'm probably gonna do around 1800 to 2200 just to make sure that it's less than the bucket, and the bucket can overcome the thumb. All right, while we got the welder hooked up, I'm gonna go ahead and fix this coupling. So that should capture the bolt like it was when it was made. Basically, I just put a little tack weld on the bolt to hold it. The bolt itself is actually a locking style bolt. That should hold the wedge on. All right, so we got it on. We checked for leaks. Actually, did not have the right hydraulic fitting to do the pressure, so I wasn't able to really put it through its test. I did end up changing the valve. I'll show you that here in a second. I'll go around the whole thing and show you the finished installation. There's a valve on these John Deere's and many others for two-way operation, and I had to turn that valve. It was only set up for hammer. But it works good. It moves easy. Folds up out of the way. I'm really happy with it. The cylinder has not broken my weld yet. We'll see. Time will tell. Anyway, let me take you around the machine and I'll crank it up and show you kind of how it works. All right, so here's the finished install. We painted where I grinded. I basically ground this off so that clip would fit still. Here's kind of close up of it. And basically this actually lands here, so it still clears this. And I end up with a tooth almost maybe an inch away from this. Which if I get a bigger bucket, it'll probably cross. But it does hit this. I could round this bucket out a little bit. I may do that just to make it fit a little tighter if I can't grab really small rocks. Let's see if I can get down here. Okay, there's where we welded that bolt up and made it like the factory one. It's just got a regular old high strength bolt. Made a little bit of a mess there. I ended up these quick couplers. Mine that was on the boom, it had a little burr in it. And I actually took that off, put it in the lathe, and just took a file and just gently took that burr off, cleaned it up. This is the weld, and just spray painted it. And you know, the welds didn't end up being beautiful. I'm not outdoors, I just basically have a windbreak, but air's still coming through, and not a perfect weld, but it'll hold. There may be try to get a closer shot of what that looks like there, so you can see there's a clip there, and basically I ground this face off right here. More shots of how I routed the lines. The main thing is just keeping everything tight. I do like the fact that they, I would have preferred it to actually be over here on this side, but having one in the center and one here, both up at the top, they've actually made this cylinder where it has a metal line down. That makes it a lot easier to deal with and keeps everything nice and compact. You can see there that hose basically wants to ride right up next to the boom, and the other side's very similar. All right, so let's jump in the excavator now and let's see what this thing does. John Deere, it is pilot control on the auxiliary, so you can control the speed and the pressure. I need to set my relief pressure still. When that comes all the way up, there's just a little gap on the hydraulic cylinder. It bottoms out on the boom rather than bottoming out on the hydraulic cylinder. That's kind of how it meets up with a bucket. That's full extension there. Okay, that's pretty much it for this install. All I really have to do is do the pressure. I don't know that I'll do a video for that. Basically, I bought a pressure kit off of eBay. They're fairly simple, and I'll go to the probably Napa and have them make me up a hose that I can connect. I'll probably break the connections there at the cylinder. Those are the easiest ones to get to, and they're common. They're the same thing. Please don't forget to subscribe, and I appreciate the, you know, ringing the bell. Gets a little more views, and that way nobody misses any content. And we'll see you on the next one. Thanks for watching.